बायोडायवर्सिटी कंजर्वेशन। कंजर्वेशन ऑफ बायोडायवर्सिटी अकर्स बाय टू मेथड्स, इनसीटू कंजर्वेशन एंड एक्सीटू कंजर्वेशन। नाउ वी डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज इनसीटू कंजर्वेशन एंड व्हाट आर द टाइप्स ऑफ इनसीटू कंजर्वेशन। इनसीटू कंजर्वेशन मीन्स protection of biodiversity through a network of protected area. What is protected area? Protected area means where biological diversity along with natural resources are present. It includes national park, sanctuary, biosphere reservoir, hotspot and sacred groups. First we talk about national park. These are the area maintained by government and reserved for wildlife. Cultivation, grazing, forestry are not allowed in national park. In India, total 92 national park present till 2005. It occupies 1.1% geographical area of India. Jim Corbett National Park is the first national park which was established in 1936 in India. Then number 2, sanctuary. These are the area with or without lake where fauna means wildlife, wild animals, can take refuge without being hunted. Collection of forest product, harvesting of timber, etc. allowed. Private ownership also allowed in sanctuary. India has more than 500 sanctuaries till 2005. It occupies 3.6% land area. Number 3, biosphere reservoir. Protected area meant for preserving genetic diversity in ecosystem and protecting wild population is called biosphere reservoir. In 1975, UNESCO created biosphere reservoir under MAB program. MAB means Man and Biosphere program, which was launched in 1971. Total number of biosphere reservoirs are 408 in 94 countries. There are three zones present in biosphere reservoir. Number 1, core zone or natural zone. Number 2, buffer zone. And number 3, transition or manipulation zone. In core zone, no human activity is allowed. The area is undisturbed and legally protected ecosystem area. Then we talk about buffer zone. In buffer zone is applicable for research and education purposes. Then we talk about transition or manipulation zone. The outermost or peripheral part of biosphere reservoir is called transition zone, where local people activities are allowed like settlement, cropping, recreation, forestry and other economic uses without disturbing ecology. Then hotspot. These are high density biodiversity area. Ecologically, hotspots are determined by four factors: species diversity, means total number of species, degree of endemism, degree of threat, and degree of exploitation. Mayer in 1988 identified 12 hotspots initially, and later he added four other in their list. Now total number of hotspots are about 34. In India, three hotspots are present. These are Indo-Burma, Western Ghat and Sri Lanka, and Himalaya. Then sacred groups. In many cultures, tracts of forest were set aside and all the trees and wildlife within were venerated and given total protection. Example, Khasi and Jayanta Hills in Meghalaya, Aravalli Hills of Rajasthan, Western Ghat region of Karnataka and Maharashtra, Chanda and Bastar of Madhya Pradesh. These are the examples of sacred groves. This is all about in situ conservation. In next video, we are going to discuss about different types of ex situ conservation. Thank you.